Hi all, welcome back to Edgewood channel. So today we are discussing a different topic, that is site of blood collection. So in the field we need to check for hemoprotozoans or other blood-borne infections. So we need to know the physical parameters and the biochemical parameters of the blood. So we will be collecting blood and preserving it and storing it and sending it for the laboratorial examinations. So first of all, the basic thing is to collect the blood. So we cannot collect direct blood from the venipuncture or cardiac puncture and all. So there are several sites in the animal bodies where we will be getting the veins very easily, so that you can get the blood very easily. So if you haven't subscribed this channel yet, feel free to subscribe and hit the bell button. So the site of blood collection. For routine hematological examination, generally venous blood is collected. So this is actually a list which is containing the species of animal and the site of blood collection. So you can get it and have a screenshot. So in case of mouse, the sites that the main used is submandibular vein, located at the back of jaw veins, draining the eye and facial region. So tail vein microsampling is normally done. Lateral tail vein cardiac puncture is also done. So in case of rats, facial or submandibular vein or tail vein is used. For rabbit, marginal ear vein and sometimes the carotid artery and central artery also used. In case of dog, we'll be using the cephalic vein, which is mainly in the hand, and in case of the hind limb, we'll be using the lateral saphenous vein. So sometimes you can also use the jugular vein if at all the animal is in a easy way to collect the blood. So in case of cats, we'll be using the cephalic vein and medial saphenous or femoral vein. Cattle and bison, jugular vein. We'll be using the jugular vein. First of all, we should restrain the animal properly before collecting the blood. The jugular vein will be easily visible. So you can see the collection. We are also using the tail vein, that is midway along the body of tail vertebrae. We'll be getting the tail vein. So in case of wild animals, that is a tiger and lion, we'll be using lateral caudal vein. For elephants, we'll be using the ear vein. Sometimes in case of large ruminants, we'll be using ear vein, like in cattle and buffalo and bison and all, we'll be using ear vein. For sheep and deer, we'll be using the jugular vein. Vein actually lies among the imaginary line from the middle of animal's eye down the side of the neck. In case of horse also, we'll be using the jugular vein. First of all, we should actually raise the vein by palpation. Also, you can go for facial signs. In case of birds, we'll be using the jugular vein. It's actually large enough to collect blood from small birds and been easily accessed by the featherless tract. So, in case of chelonians, we'll be using the jugular vein, which will be lying the laterally and superficially on the neck. Also, supravertebral vein lies in the midline on ventral aspect of carapace. Dorsal coccygeal vein is also used. For reptiles, we'll be using the ventral coccygeal vein lies on the midline ventral aspect of vertebrae. Ventral abdominal vein is also used. For snakes, we'll be sometimes using cardiocentesis, that is direct blood taking from the heart. Also, you can use for the ventral coccygeal vein, which will be lying in the ventral midline of coccygeal vertebrae. Thank you.